So all of us, when we meditate on ourselves as a Yidam deity, such as Avalokiteshvara, we have the material within our nature. We have the raw material. We have the twofold purity. We have the basis or the twofold purity, the raw materials within ourselves. And so for that reason, when we meditate upon ourselves as a Yidam deity, it's not like we are just imagining ourselves to be the Yidam deity or pretending that we're the Yidam deity.
아, 다들 이제 이담 공부해봤디. 그봐 김선생님이 다 나랑 간지내려오지 마시래. 다들 이제는 주원님이 주고 이담 가르 공부했어. 이담 안 보시죠? 제가 지난해 이담 가르 공부했어야지 좋아지 용으로.
So that's the first question that comes up. And I've explained the reasons and the purpose for meditating on ourselves as the deities. Now the second question that comes up is, which deity should we visualize ourselves as? There are so many different Yidam deities. Here we have 26 different tankas or paintings of the Yidam deities. And I think that when you look at them, there probably isn't anyone here who could identify all of them. So today we have actually added the names to the tankas. And you can see here that there are various different deities. And there are 26 deities here. Now, the story behind these tankas is that originally these tankas are based on tankas that were drawn by the 8th Siddhi Rinpoche, Siddhu Chukyi Jungne. And so these are the guru's tradition of the tankas. So there are 27 tankas in the series in total. And we were able to get them because we were able to have photographs of the originals that were in a museum and taken. And we are now, we have now hung them all here.
Garza di Tepsi Yungdua, Yidam Plan German Jagi, Kubara Yuding, Tepsi Yungdua. That is usually the San Tenina, but in Yops, Yops of Summer, Tabe, Mantachin, Karin, Karimi, what you ask him? Dozip Hamachibule, German, but Nishizara is. The name is Karin, Karimenta.
I used to think that I would be able to identify most of the Yidam deities, but these days you can get these picture books, coffee table books with many different pictures of tankas, and there's so many of them. It's hard to know which deity is which. There are over 20 forms of Vajravarahi alone. So which one is which? It's really difficult to tell, very difficult to identify which deity there are. There are thousands of Yidam deities, and so it can be really difficult to decide which one you should meditate upon.
但以呢呀，伊达芒古耶维呢，说是灭吧，三难扎住，说是那就开吧，当，俺那就开吧七修那个，开吧七修灭吧七修，俺达配给这边呢，说是有高修，但伊达姆罗卡里呢呀，这个我们这个嘞是，大概的第一个王托，第一个王花公超别，那王托别建立啊，这个我们这个嘞是。
But basically, whichever deity you have the greatest feeling for, whichever what deity you have the greatest faith in, and so it's the one that you have the most faith for, the one that you have the most interest in, and to put it colloquially, your favorite deity, it's fine to meditate on that deity. Once you receive the empowerment, get permission to the empowerment for that deity, and get the permission, then it's fine to meditate on it.
Da, ini yang kau dili ya, kamu sangat luli ya. Jadi, tujuh nen jero mah, kau mesti, kau gak bersumber ya.
But here in the Karmakamsan tradition, it said that you need to visualize yourself as Vajrayogini. So one reason for this is that Vajravarahi, from one perspective, Vajravarahi was the secret Yidam deity of Marpa, Milarepa, and Gampopa. So Marpa, Milarepa, and Gampopa are the forefathers of the Kagyu lineage. So the followers of the Kagyu lineage need to see, are we able to do as they have done? And so that is one reason why we visualize on Varahi as the Yidam deity. In particular, people who meditate on Mahamudra need to meditate on Vajravarahi.
Karelesana, Dozi Pamundi, Chakachimun Hinji Gema, Chakachimun Sunji Chabi.
And the reason is because Vajravarahi represents the co-emergent Mahamudra. In particular, in our Karmakaju tradition, Gampopa gave the first Karmapa Dusim Kempa two practices for the creation and the completion phases. For the creation phase, he gave him the creation phase practice of Vajravarahi. And for the completion phase, he gave him the instructions on the inseparability of the pranas and mind. And so this is another reason why Vajravarahi is so important.
이내야 도지 낸주름아 고발래야 도지 낸주름이 왕 토구요아래 이나 도지 낸주름이 왕디 에네 까짓 탐바 데리 차리요아래 드림 윈 유산에 디 균세나 데네 약간 좀 먼저 지금 도지 낸주름이 왕 고스에서 탐지해라 도지 낸주름이 왕 차야지 쳐가 말해 드림 윈 유산에 다 디 균세나 데네 엔 다리 디에 콜로 된 쇼기 그래서 왕 채브레 제사다 디기 도시 낸주름이 왕게 고 고 최배 소식 도시민 유산에 콜로 대조 왕 탑장 야부계 왕 탑장 아니 용기 용 다제 용 검사 바지 여린이가 검사다 용 바지 검사 오면 로아서 말 도시 정도 다만지 어래 가서
But to visualize yourselves as Vajrayogini, you need to have the empowerment of Vajrayogini. However, the empowerment of Vajrayogini is very strictly restricted. And you can't just give it to any, in any old occasion. It's very strictly restricted. So for this reason, I have given the empowerment of Chakrasamvara. And I think that this will serve as the empowerment, can serve as the empowerment for Vajravarahi. Because of Chakrasamvara is the father aspect. And I think once you've received the empowerment for the father aspect, then it is okay to meditate upon the mother aspect as well.
Tandona, Ji, Dojipamo, Gomtuna, Ji, De Gamsangi, Mundutangain, Dojipamo, Gomtuna, Abore, Tate Gomatuna, Taidam Ganunji, number Jeshane, Manduske, or Mane.
And so here, if you're able to practice, if you're able to visualize yourselves as Vajravarahi, particularly if you're doing the Karma Kamsan preliminaries, that's good. But if you're not able to visualize yourselves as Varahi, then you can visualize yourselves as any Yidam deity. And now I'll read a little bit more from the text.
장기 지원 여기 나와 쓰기 얘기들 무지 질하제 회상에 가게 되는 배만 다 외대나 뒤숨 상계 담지 뉘병어 자야라만이 나바 도시 상계 치르지 깜주 갑들라 자야라만의 도시 상라 모두 그 버거 유계라만 투지 주주베 타거도 진주 차다서 주주 주도 자주 소다 시야 조신 추루 남대 시제 주 노정 유베라만 진들 제바 이담 상계 자선 보고 가는 최경선 소다 제베 권내 주고 대다게 뇌내 전담 용주 담이 예매도 시고르면 카즈미 무빙인 타바네 규베 둥 슈다 동행 아로다 지데 차당고 보소기 세다 오미춘이 소기 예나디 모남체 자신 규디소 선디 기디 강을 마남 시고르다 캬바라 제디 기기 도지숭 선디 츠강 주부 이셴도 메이 마 창사 타르반데 남소기 왕구로 사다베 타고르기 코노 외도 슈네 유벨라말라 팀 유벨라말르 넘버 찍을 찍 팀네 외도 슈 사야라말라 팀 군주 군주인 오르기 자완의 의사가 붙어 랑의 민속수 팅 소셜수 리기 드바 타 분배왕 톱 남주수 계름고 말라 왕 드부트구 톱에 개발전도 제 디해징제대 라멘 드번의 의사만 붙어 랑의 드버팀 준수왕 아가 드바다 사용왕도 서른고 말라 왕 농구 드베 개발전도 제 투간의 의사만 붙어 닌가르팀 로다수 이지다 시럽이 시경왕도 염주고 말라 왕 이게 고라 노사 할때 죽을 줄이 계신세 내 순간에 의사 까마티수 채 땡딩인가르팀 시딤 윤딤 요조기 뒤에 고순 창의 위주 바다 왕시와도 차게스물이 동예매 공발 왕은 이걸 줄이 개발체도 채 라레 무구 자부증이 제베 경기 라마 예베 신수당다 제도 외기 공부르시네 랑기 지원네 인가르팀 라메 두다 랑생 예매도 주부르면 남버토베 파르마주베 샘 람밥 쥐레메베 가나 진유스 냐버샤 텔레란데 나와 치셔 라메 구인 남기 나서버 자로 창세 송자동 난데란데 이 유진 지중 지셔 도지 이시기 람자도 메라 겨왕오 춘섭수 안 드로에스 예저기 남거 벤데데라 라마 슈발라 고아체범이 서동기센 딤버베메 라마 슈발라 서동 뒤지슈 쳬버메 마주에 담지 센데 루두 담지 라메 샤도 임버 곰녜웨스 닝거 라마 춘카와 슈베 외기 류다 내가 담지 세월 곰 대행안도 니도 로르자 세마타도 라마 지위주도 슈버메 대규데 센데자 데베세한테 더곰 내가나 그래서 상화체베 세나야 푸 라마라 응에서 미기관에 무 내나서 라면 구청에 가와라 뒤집어 내 삼지 주인이 다 내 뒤집 중에 탑서 라면 칠랍린 중에 미워라 가와금 연기 춘추 중에 라면 칠리기로 바랑라 기회 그만 민자브르메 너나 니기 중에 라면 칠랍 룽에 중에 라면 툼지를 겁니 무급회의 대를 잡아마도 빵인신을 민수하는 내 담바오
She is also the secret yidam of Marpa Milarepa and Gampopa. Due to these interdependent connections, here the custom is to visualize her. Imagine that above your head or in the sky in front of you is a jeweled throne supported by 8 snow lions and covered with fine divine fabrics. On top of it, on a lotus moon seat, is the combined essence of all the Buddhas of the 3 times, your root guru in the form of Vajradhara, as in the practice for going for refuge. In a column above him are the Kagyu masters up through Vajradhara, surrounded by an ocean of the siddhas of the practice lineage, such as the Drikun, Drukpa, Tsalpa, Taklun, and so forth. Additionally, the gurus of the lineage of the great perfection, the 6 yogas, path and result, pacification, chit, mind training gather like clouds. Surrounding them are the gatherings of yidams, buddhas, bodhisattvas, heroes, dakinis, dharma protectors, and guardians. These have been wholly established from the very beginning, present as the inseparable Samaya and wisdom beings. With devotion that is not mere words, with the strength of dedication from the depths of your heart and a cry of longing, pray, pervasive Lord whose nature is of all things, and so forth. Offer the 7 branches and aspirations by reciting the prayer beginning in the Dharma Expense Palace of Akanishta, and recite the long or short supplications such as the Mahamudra lineage prayer as appropriate. Then, without allowing your mind to be distracted by anything else, recite and accumulate the 4-line prayer, My Mother's Throughout Space, and in particular, the 6-line supplication that is the Vajra words of Lord Dusan Kempa. At the end, supplicate the glorious gurus and others to grant you empowerment. Due to this, the surrounding retinue melts into light and dissolves into the lineage gurus. The lineage gurus then melt one into another. They melt into light and dissolve into your root guru, who becomes the essence of all 3 jewels combined. White light radiates from his forehead and dissolves into the space between your eyebrows. This purifies obscurations of body, such as killing. You receive the Va's empowerment and are empowered to meditate on the creation phase during the time of the path. You become a fortunate one who will achieve the Nirmanakaya as a result. In a similar fashion, red light radiates from the guru's throat and dissolves into your throat, purifying your obscurations of speech, such as lying. You receive the secret empowerment and are empowered to meditate on the channels and winds. You become a fortunate one who will achieve the Sambhogakaya. Blue light radiates from the guru's heart and dissolves into your heart, purifying mental obscurations, such as wrong views. You then receive the Prajna wisdom empowerment and are empowered to meditate on the absorption. You become a fortunate one who will attain the Dharmakaya. White, red, and blue lights radiate from the Guru's 3 places and dissolve into your forehead, throat, and heart. This purifies the obscurations that are equally of body, speech, and mind, and contained within the afflictive and cognitive obscurations, as well as the obscurations of absorption. You receive the 4th empowerment and are empowered to meditate on a Mahamudra, inseparable awareness and emptiness. You become a fortunate one who will achieve the essence Kaya. Once again, in response to your fervent devotion, the Guru, with a pleased, radiant smile, melts into a globe of light that enters you through your crown of your head and dissolves into your heart. Imagine that the Guru's mind and your mind become inseparable, and let your mind rests evenly as long as you can in the uncontrived, uncontaminated nature, uninterrupted by thought. When you arise from that, think that whatever appearances arise are the various manifestations of the Guru's body. All sounds are their speech, are the empty yet audible natural sound of the channels. Whatever movement and thoughts arise in the mind are the spontaneous energy of Vajra wisdom, then dedicate the merit. Between meditation sessions, when you are walking, think that you are circumambulating the Guru, who is seated on the lotus moon seat in the sky to your right. When eating or drinking, imagine that your food and drink melt into nectar that you offer to your Guru, who is seated on a red lotus in your throat. Meditate that everything you say is a supplication and that all movement, sitting, and activities are service to the Guru. When going to sleep, meditate that the Guru, an inch in size, sits in the center of your heart and that his light illuminates your body and room. Fall asleep in that state as soon as you wake up, imagine the Guru sitting on the crown of your head and pray to him with great faith and devote dedication. Also meditate in this way when you are sitting. When you get a new house, clothes, or so forth, offer the best of these to the Guru, actually or mentally. When ill, imagine the Guru, an inch in size, at the location of the illness. Think that nectar drips from him, cleansing and purifying all sickness. Imagine that all illness, misdeeds, and obscurations are methods of purification that come from the Guru's blessings, and meditate on joy. If demonic displays arise, think that these are the play of the Guru's activity, urging you to practice virtue. In brief, meditate that any happiness that occurs is the Guru's blessing, and any suffering that occurs is also the Guru's compassion. Use these as supports to increase your devotion, and do not look elsewhere for ways to remedy them or rid yourselves of them. This is a crucial point.
미바치즈디디슈이인다다데야드라마송안드라마송은냐차당차통안드바지양캉가시에어산제나정고인데에베나안가시바친이나신나데사마마모디데네드라만데에시차통야인다
So this is enough for the morning session. In the afternoon, I will describe the visualizations. Now at this point, we will recite the Tara practice, and at the same time we will serve tea. You can drink your tea. If you have to go to the restrooms, you can go to the bathrooms or the washrooms. So some of you can go, but if you don't have to go, then you should stay where you are and recite Tara.
라멘엔조 튠실라멘엔조 튠실라멘엔조 순아래 디 스크린 토리 요르베 튠실라멘엔조 디 스크린 토리 요아래 샤이도 아래 저 참으로 님도 되어 주었다
And then at 10 a.m. we will have the Guru Yoga practice, the four-session Guru Yoga. And the text will be displayed on the screen so everyone can recite together.
是台湾救狗协会及救狗园区，基于众生平等、慈悲相待之理念，慈悲置业于2007年成立台湾救狗协会，原本是以收容弃养之流浪狗为救护对象，使其免遭扑杀。后因收养的流浪狗日益增多，进而成立专门照顾流浪狗的养护园区。 然而，园区的扩建速度仍旧赶不上流浪狗的快速增加。于是，另安置近300只狗孩迁移到中华护生协会的两所园区，令其获得安养。于2014年7月份统计，救狗协会至少救护了超过8000只流浪狗，目前与护生协会 共同护养近1000只的狗孩与养护园区。除了救护流浪狗之外，救狗协会并长期提供素食狗饲料给其他照顾流浪狗的爱心人士，已经常与护生协会合作，透过各类相关活动，呼吁大众重视生命、爱惜生命，使人与万物之间 皆能互爱共存，消弭暴力之气，促进社会祥和。
岁末总回向， 慈悲置业花莲中心举办祈福消灾超荐法会，恭送金光明最圣王经，点灯供水药供甘露施食暨佛前大供，恭请常住法师主法。日期1月1日星期日到1月2日星期一，时间上午9点开始，地点花莲中心，花莲市建国路160号，电话0383116730。0383116730，敬请与会菩萨全程配合防疫保护措施。供佛斋天净护法，前辈香花酥陀果，祈愿佛法永兴隆，法界众生皆安乐。新春供佛斋天祈福法会，恭请广护法师及法务指导僧众共同领众，日期2月1日星期三大年十一，时间上午9点开始，地点宜兰大悲观音道场，宜兰县三星乡三星路2段20号，电话0398993190398993190，0398993190，宜兰大悲观音道场，敬邀菩萨参与熏习，同沾法义，共沐佛恩。疫情期间参与共修，请务必遵守防疫规定。
在法身一界之中，没有任何事物不是清净圆满的。从上方的圣者坛城到下方的地狱世界，一切都是平等的清净圆满。因此，不论是在痛苦的状态，或在觉醒的状态，都没有差别。诸佛与有情众生之间也没有不同。此外，这不是刚刚创造的事物，而是自始及任运现前，因此佛果法身是自明的觉性，透过上师的指导而当下得见，并且由于它并非可修得或达到的，故它是清净的圆满。除了这个之外，我没有其他可教导的，所以要好好把它放在心中。卡千女，卡千公主，错家佛母请求上师莲华生大士为上中下根者的利益，开示这三种禅修的教言。他为后世记录下这些教言。由于这些教法并非为了在当时宣扬，错家佛母便将它们藏匿起来，而成为珍贵的地福藏。愿具有业缘的瑜伽士得遇这些教法，未来当有福报的你们得遇这些法教时，一，你对见地自信的了悟，也许有如海洋，但仍应守护最细微的世俗因果。二，你可能已了解法性自信的大海，但仍应保持不散乱的禅修，有如黄金打造的柱子。三，你可能已经了悟广阔心的枉然状态，但仍要守护你的三昧耶与戒律，让它们稳定且无有损坏。四，你可能已经获得如海般法性自信的了证，但仍要敬重崇高的上师众，有如你头上的冠冕。五，你慈爱的心也许没有偏私，但仍应满足你的伴侣与所有法友的愿望。 六，你也许已经看见佛与一切众生的平等性，但仍应避免如毒药般的食不善业与其果报。
接下来请收看修心百颂。
修行百颂是十一世纪的伟大学者帕汤巴桑杰的心灵证言，由顶果钦哲法王加以论释。帕汤巴停留在西藏和尼泊尔边境的听瑞地区很长一段时间，拥有无数个弟子。有一天，一个亲近弟子在久违之后抵达听瑞，看到上师如此年迈而感到非常悲伤，于是他问圣者，当你离开这个世间的时候，毫无疑问的，你将从一个净土到另一个净土，但我们将会如何？我们能够信任谁？面对热泪盈眶的弟子，帕当巴教导了修行百颂。修行百颂意义深奥又简明易懂，诚挚认真的修行者将发现，这些寄颂中的所有教导都是正统佛法修持不可或缺的精髓。
从根本而言，没有所谓的迷惘，它的升起只是暂时的。听闻的人们啊，检视造成迷惘升起的原因的本质。
无论你多么努力地擦洗黑炭，都无法把它洗成白炭。我们可以想象，无明是自信的一部分，如同黑色是煤炭的一部分。果真如此，无明和迷惘就无法被根除。事实上，无明和迷惘不具有任何真实的存在，它们无法改变我们本具的自信。佛性，佛性如黄金般纯然且不受改变，无明至多可以暂时遮蔽佛性，但佛性本质却不会改变。在某些因缘之下，无明暂时形成，一如天空的云朵暂时遮蔽了太阳的灿烂光辉，但是当我们飞向云朵，进入云朵之时，却无法触摸到云朵。在这之前，云朵不存在，最后也将消失在稀薄的空气中。至于太阳，则从未改变，完全没有受到云朵的影响。无明制造的障壁是偶然升起的，是短暂的，是无可知取的，它们无法改变或影响我们的本然自信，也不是本然自信的一部分。无明，一切迷惘之根源，诱惑众生进入轮回。然而，无论无明看似多么坚实， 它也从来不具有一丝一毫的实相。既然无明从未升起，那么它也无法存在，更别说去指灭它的存在。一旦对于空性的了悟，去除了无明的障蔽，成佛之自然本质将显现。一旦风吹散了云朵，从未停止照耀的太阳将显露出来。
心无旁骛地专注于修持殊胜的佛法，听闻的人们啊，他将在死亡之后引导你。
正甚之青春年华赐予我们健康和力量，热切地想要享受人生。我们怀着不灭的热忱，竭尽所能地来增加财富与权势。对一些人来说，达成自己的目标，同时意味着要损害他人的利益。然而在死亡的时候，我们将了悟，所有占据我们心神的事物是多么虚荣无益。但是到了那个时候，要回头已经太迟了。至美的事物从未能够诱惑死亡，至巨的财富无法贿赂它，至大的力量或权势无法迫使死亡等待片刻。一国之君也必须遵从他的召唤，他将卸除将军的武装，即使他拥有一个威力强大的军械库。在死亡的时刻，我们在一生中所获得的灵修觉受是唯一的助力。赶快让我们在老迈夺走体能与智力之前修行，让我们背弃凡俗生活的迷惑与幼稚散乱，全心修持佛法。那么在死亡时，就会如无与伦比的冈波巴大师所说的，最好的情况是我们将了悟究竟本质及法身；中等的情况是我们肯定将投身净土，充满喜乐，如同孩子回归家园；最差的情况是我们将了无悔恨，因为我们已遇见上师，并如实地修持他们给予的法教。让我们从此时此刻开始准备，在死亡的时刻，我们所领受的法教将能够派上用场。
因果业报的真理必然使行为结出果实，听闻的人们啊，避免所有负面与邪恶的行为。
假若死亡只是意味着我们将如水被干涸的地面吸收，或如熄灭之火焰般消失，那么我们可以不去在意死亡。然而情况并非如此，死亡之时，我们舍弃了肉身，却保留了心事。这个心事在死亡与投身之间的过渡状态中，称为中阴游走。在中阴状态下，我们没有有形的身体，无法如常地使用五种感官。我们被迫脱离父母和朋友的陪伴，如同一根从一团奶油中抽出的毛发。尽管如此，有一件事物却如影随形，我们过去的所作所为。如果恶行较多，我们将无法逃脱轮回下三道的痛苦。相反的，如果善行较多，我们将投身上三道，继续朝解脱迈进。当我们的心在中阴多变的体验里游走的时候，我们既无法选择去做有利于自己的事， 也无法从从容容地去决定要走哪一个方向。我们没有出路，如同风中的羽毛，我们受到自身业力的迫使，被死亡的士兵拖着走。我们没有暂时喘息的片刻，好让自己振作起来。我们无法随意停留或离去。我们的心神被抛过来丢过去，不听我们的使唤。要了解并相信因果法则，主宰宇宙和一切众生，这一点是重要的。密勒日巴尊者说，如果他能够全心奉献于佛法，并在这一生中获得证悟，乃是他确信业知法则的缘故。每一个行为无可避免的都会有一个结果，我们行善或行恶的痕迹留存于心事的下层。要消除恶行的痕迹，只有两个方法：一是经受恶业所带来的自然后果痛苦；二是在可怕的业果出现之前，用适当的对治解药来清净恶业。当上师告诉我们所有的善行和恶行具有不可避免的后果的时候，我们听得清楚明白，但不是真正相信他的话。如果我们真的相信，我们就不敢犯下最微小的恶行，反而会大大的着重于从事所有的善行，即使是最微不足道的善行。难道一个人会去管金块有多小，而不珍视它吗？
把所有事物留在身后，犹如南柯一梦。听闻的人们啊，只要把无为付诸实修。
凡俗人生的各种事物，如同海浪般，一个接着一个而来。富者永远觉得拥有的金钱不够，权者永远觉得拥有的权势不足。思维以下的话语，满足我们所有的欲望，满足我们所有计划的最佳方式，就是放弃他们。一个证悟者把凡夫俗子热衷的事物视若梦境，如同一个老人观看孩子嬉戏般看待他们。昨晚你或许梦见自己是一个伟大的国王，但是当你清醒之后留下了什么？你在清醒时所体验的事物几乎不比梦境真实。与其去追求难以捉摸的梦，你应该让自己的心安住于宁静无扰的禅思，离于烦乱散漫，直到对空性的了悟成为你的觉受不可或缺的一部分。
放下凡是你所执着的事物，听闻的人们啊，没有任何一件事物是你需要的。
想一想，任何一个让你强烈执着的人、物品或情况，并试着去检视你所深深执着的美好事物、权力或财富，彻头彻尾的检视他们每一个。他们看起来不像是幻象吗？当你用这种方式来看待事物的时候，你的执着减少了，不再有相同的急需去拥有的感觉。如果你有我不需要任何东西的态度，你的心境将自然而然地感到宁静自由。另一方面，如果你在活着与死亡的时候都处于强烈执着的状态下，那么你的今生 与来生都将充满痛苦折磨。在死时强烈执着于身后物的人，将变成一个受贪欲折磨的恶鬼。过去的伟大圣者与行者，只要有维生所必需的最少量食物以及足以避寒的衣物，就感到心满意足。然而他们是最富有的人，因为真正的财富属于那些知道如何满足于现状的人。伟大的噶当派禅修者噶拉贡丘住在西藏的一处洞穴中，每次他进出洞穴的时候，身上穿的袍子都会被洞口的山楂丛妨碍到。他常常考虑砍掉山楂丛，但每每如此，他心中立刻就会升起死亡的念头。他想，谁晓得我什么时候会死呢？把去除这株长刺的树丛所花的时间用来禅修比较好。借由禅定的力量，噶拉贡丘能够飞行，试显各种神机。他圆寂时，那个山楂丛仍在原地。假若如此伟大的行者都无法忍受去浪费片刻的时间，那么在修行道上仍有如此多的事情需要完成的我们，怎能把人生绝大部分的时间耗费在俗物之上？
既然你不会永远留在这个世间，听闻的人们啊，那么现在就开始准备你的旅程。
在我们之中，谁没有想过去建造一幢坚固牢靠的房子，可以让我们住在里面数十年，并在我们离开世间之后还能维持数个世纪？谁不曾梦想致富，在余生免于所有的忧虑？是永恒的恶魔诓骗了我们，让我们相信事物能够持久。相信任何人事物永远属于我们，注定会令我们失望。这是多么悲惨的景象啊！目睹人们在死亡时，心思完全被所爱之人与所留下的身后物占据。遗言除了一连串的执着之外无他，完全无视于等待在他们前面的命运。如果他们完全忽略任何具有真实意义的事物，那么他们所要面对的命运很可能是充满痛苦折磨的。相反的，圣者与真正的行者不认为自己拥有任何事物，甚至连自己的身体也是如此，更别说财物或住所。听到这样的事迹，或遇见这样的圣者或行者，是多么令人有所启发啊！他们是财物为暂时借来的虚幻之物。